Runter, es sind noch 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
2, 1. Oktoberfest! Alright! It's that time of year again. And this has become an annual tradition with you and me, Jerry.
Yeah, that's true. I got my lederhosen on.
Yeah, you weren't prepared last year, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, of course. I have synthetic lederhosen, I don't have the real thing.
You know what? This is going to be very difficult to do a bit to, so I'm going to pivot.
Just getting into it.
That better?
Yeah, it's the perfect music to march into Czechoslovakia with.
Still. There we go. All right, it's Oktoberfest 2020.
Jawohl.
Oh, Zapfdis!
Okay. I gotta find. Keep talking, guys. I got two guys here. You should be carrying the weight here. I'm trying to.
I don't know what you're doing. I'm just okay. I don't know. All of a sudden, for some reason, I'm in very much in a marching mood. I don't know why.
All right.
Well, so I got my.
Are we going to be quizzed? Is that what's happening here?
Yeah, although I can't seem to control my.
Your band's out of control. There you go.
Yeah, I can't control the music here. Okay. So I thought I would start off some interesting Oktoberfest facts. Every year I try to find something new that I didn't know about. And then we'll go into a quiz and see how you guys do. Jerry's actually been very good at this, but I tried to stay away from the German history this time because Jerry slam dunks. Boom. Anything.
Don't throw any of those questions my way.
Exactly.
Not about that.
So everybody knows, I mean, Oktoberfest is called October, but it starts in September because of the whole wedding thing. It started in 1810.
Mm-hmm.
Mainly because the weather is warmer, more pleasing. But let's see. Munich beer only, by the way.
Well, didn't it start in Munich?
Yeah, and it's canceled this year, of course. So we're bringing Oktoberfest to you.
Virtually.
Is there still a Rocktoberfest that used to be on the loop?
Loop, of course.
Does that still happen?
Rocktoberfest. I mean, well, the loop's gone. It's a Christian station.
They're
right?
Gone. They're gone. But I mean, is there still a Rocktober?
Isn't there
a Rocktoberfest?
I'm sure somebody, some morning zoo is doing it.
Yeah, man. Well, I think there's a new rock station. I think it's that station that used to be WLS FM.
Oh, that's right.
There's some rock music, man.
Yeah.
They're not playing the hits. The Air Supply followed by the Deep Purple.
That's right.
They're not doing that anymore.
Well, that's what happens when you cut off the Air Supply. You get become very Deep Purple.
Yeah. Okay. So it is a 210-year-old tradition. It wasn't originally a beer festival. It was to honor the marriage of Prince Ludwig and Teresa of...
Austria or something? I don't know.
You took German, right? You can pronounce that.
What is it? Where is it exactly?
Forget it. It doesn't matter.
Saxe Coburg?
Yes. Oh, no. Yeah. Hilberghausen.
Hilberghausen. Yeah, that's good enough.
Yeah. Okay. They've canceled it 24. Actually, I could say it's been canceled 25 times this year. This article was written pre-COVID. So it's 25 times now in the last 200 years. Mainly due to war conditions.
I kind of figured.
And cholera epidemics.
Well, there you go.
There you go. Not much of,
much changed.
With so much beer being consumed, it's obvious that some people might feel sick and end up puking. And that's why Adidas recently released a limited edition of vomit-proof sneakers inspired by the Oktoberfest. They're priced at 199 euros with PROST stitched on the side.
Well, isn't that special?
Prost.
That's cheers for people who don't speak German.
That's right.
Lass uns ein Toast machen.
Well, I don't mind if I do.
Okay. Let's see. Do I have any other fun facts? I thought that was...
Well, I don't know. You're the ones with the... I did hear it was about a wedding. I thought it was actually a little bit later. I didn't... No, it went back to 1810, so you got that one on me.
Yeah. Nobody raises their mug until the mayor says so. Since 1950, the festival has only started after the official gun salute and the mayor shouting, "Old Sepsis!" It's supposed to... let's see, do I have that again? Oh, yeah, I played it earlier.
Old Sepsis!
It's German for "it's tapped."
Old Sepsis! Auf eine friedliche Wiesn 2006!
Yes!
And the mayor then offers the first mug to the minister president of the state of Bavaria. Only after that can the festival start. While the festival rings in the beginning of October, the beer was traditionally brewed all the way back in March when the summer's heat and rampant bacteria wouldn't interfere with the brewing process.
Mm.
This beer, called Marzen beer, was typically higher in alcohol so it could last all summer. During October, the rest of the year's beer was consumed to make room for a new year's worth of beer. Today, the beer is still brewed under the same style, but it's now brewed right before the fall. Oktoberfest beer is typically around 6% ABV.
Well, that's not too bad.
You mean your buzz lasted all summer? Or what lasted all summer?
The beer itself, in the kegs, right?
Yeah, well, for the extra alcohol.
Yeah.
Kept it well preserved.
Buzz lasted all summer.
Oh, well.
Could be.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Well, 6% is far stronger and sweeter than the typical German lager. It's easy to get dehydrated on a warm, early fall afternoon, and many people pass out from exhaustion. And that's where the term beer lichen comes from.
I lichen beer, too.
I lichen the beer. It's German for beer corpse.
Beer corpse.
Beer lichen. He likes the beer.
And dancing mit hair.
And then down you go.
Yeah.
The reason why Oktoberfest has become such an important and popular Munich landmark is not out of mere hedonism, but necessity. Southern Bavaria was once notorious for its awful fresh water supply. So to avoid malaria.
I think you had two diseases on your brain there.
Yeah, the plague and other such nasty ailments, locals would wet their whistles with the safer, arguably tastier alternative of beer.
The plague? I mean, they had the bubonic plague or something?
I don't know what plague they're talking about here.
Yeah, when you do plague, it's very vague. Plague is very vague.
Paris Hilton was permanently banned from Oktoberfest for wearing offensive clothing.
Well, that says something there, because like most of the barmaids there running around with their boobs hanging out.
It's pretty bad she's offended them.
Yeah. Probably one of those skirt incidents.
Well, she was dressed in her skimpiest Bavarian D-I-R-N-D-L. Is that a word?
It's a drindle.
Drindle. They misspelled it wrong.
Yeah, that's probably.
It's the traditional Oktoberfest dress.
It's kind of that. Yeah, it's the, with the little vest thing boost. Yeah, you know what it looks like.
Oh, here's the real reason why. Okay, it wasn't the offensive dressing. I knew that couldn't have been the reason.
Yeah, it's Germany. They're pretty lax there.
She showed up to promote a brand of canned wine without any sort of prior arrangement with the Oktoberfest organizer.
Yeah, that's typical.
After some sizable and intoxicated public outrage, Paris was banished forever, returning to the party. Yeah, from ever returning. Yeah.
Yeah. I just think her being there, her essence was enough to get her banned.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Over recent years, organizers for the festival have tried to steer away from the image of the world's most popular watering hole to a more friendly, family-friendly extravaganza. How'd that work out for Vegas?
Not too well.
Remember that?
Yeah. We're family friendly.
They used to be family friendly, and then they came back. They went back to the what happens in
what
Vegas.
What Vegas stays in Vegas. Vegas. Yeah, you're darn right.
Yeah, you could say it.
Yeah, well, I like to edit myself occasionally.
I'm almost wrapped up here with the facts, and then we're going to get into the questions here. It could be dangerous for some. Around 600 to 800 people suffer from alcohol poisoning every year.
Yeah, okay.
Lost and found. Last year, lost items included 350 cell phones.
Okay, that makes sense.
520 unreclaimed wallets.
Yeah.
1,000 passports.
Jeez.
370 pairs of glasses, 425 sets of keys, 1,300 items of clothing, and one set of dentures. Even 48 children were lost.
How much underwear was part of that clothing?
Part of the 1,300? I don't know. It's got to be in there, though. Oh,
that's a wild night.
Wow.
Well, you know, all I have to say is, Ziga Ziga Ziga, oi, oi, oi. I lost my wallet.
Okay.
Mine wallet.
Are we ready for the quiz? We have 25 questions.
Sure.
And remember, just like last year, remember we had the correct sound? It was this. Whoa, that was loud.
Yeah, ouch.
This year it's going to be...
Post.
That's good.
That was good. And if it's wrong...
Nine.
No. Okay. That was the same last year.
Now, to avoid competition here, I'm going to go back and forth with you guys. So I'm just going to do alternating.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll start with Dave.
I'm going to...
I don't even think you need
reapply some more hand lotion here.
Okay.
For this. Get ready.
I'll just play this while you're...
I'll rub it on my brain.
Lubing up.
Lube up your brain.
Because you got to keep that hand lotion on.
Okay. Number one. Which country is the home of Oktoberfest?
Jeez. Tough.
Germany? Aleman?
Prost.
Aleman?
Okay. Deutschland?
One for Dave.
Deutschland.
You're going to have to keep track of your own score. I can't do that here.
I'm just here for the pretzels.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry, Dave. I'd offer you a pretzel if you were here. Okay.
A virtual pretzel.
Okay. Excellent. Number two, Jerry. Yeah. You're always number two.
Yeah.
What? How do you say cheers at the festival?
Cheer. Prost.
Prost.
Okay. Number three, a stein will typically cost you about how much? And I'll give you a price range, a multiple choice, Dave. A, €1 each. B, 9 to 10 euros each. C, 25 euros each. D, 50 euros each. One stein of beer.
Well,
euro is about a dollar.
We're
going to
jack it up for the party. So I'll go with, I don't even know what the exchange rate is for a euro.
I think it's about 1-1, isn't it?
No, we're a little bit less than a euro.
Yeah.
It's like 90 cents to like one or 80 cents to 1 euro.
I'll say C.
$25
is giving you more than a pint, right? Tells you what I know.
Well, you get
nine.
Yeah,
actually, the answer is
you're not
nine.
You're not talking about like a stein of
beer.
Like
how much
gallon.
Is a stein actually?
When you think of a stein of beer, I'm always thinking about the actual like the actual vessel itself too.
Like a pint, it's more than a pint, isn't it?
Oh yeah,
yeah.
A stein. I'm gonna say C, because they're gonna jack up the price.
Hey Alexa, how much is a stein of beer? Oh, sorry, I need to turn her up.
$25.60.
Let's try it again.
How many ounces is a stein of beer? Oh, no. Hey, Alexa, how many ounces is a stein of beer?
One stein of beer is 224 ounces.
Oh, jeez. 224 ounces?
I was thinking an entire six pack.
Well, that's unbelievable. It's only 9 to 10 euros each.
It's like $11, $12 for that much beer.
Okay, I don't trust. No, there's no way a stein is what'd you say, 260?
No, 240. Did you say? I can't remember now. It was 200, over 200. I know that. Ounces.
Okay.
Yeah, that can't be right.
No. Man, this.
No wonder people are like beer corpses. You drink that much in just one sitting?
Beer liking. Okay. Number four.
So did I get that right or no?
No, you said 25 euros each. I would have gone with...
I said the third one. Oh, that was too much.
Yeah.
Too high. Okay.
Too high.
I thought they were jacking it up for...
The tourists? Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's got to be cheap enough if there are that many drunks.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Number four. Which is the which of the following is not a food usually associated with Oktoberfest? A, Händel, which is grilled chicken. Mm. B, Brezel, which is a pretzel. C, Schweinshaxe, which is a pork knuckle. Or Tintenfisch, fried calamari.
Tintenfisch.
Post.
That's pretty obvious.
Number five, Dave.
It was? Why was it obvious?
Fried calamari.
Yeah.
Think about the...
That's not very German.
Yeah, pretzels, pork knuckles, chicken.
Wasn't the question which one is not?
Not a food, yeah.
And that's what I said.
So it's calamari?
Calamari is not.
Yeah, that's okay. I thought you said the other one.
No. All the other ones. Brezel? Brezel's totally. And the pig knuckle? Come on.
Number five, which animals do not participate in the Oktoberfest costume and rifleman parade? A, cows, B, goats, C, thoroughbred horses, D, llamas.
Oh, jeez. These are real.
Is that really one of the...
Yeah.
I don't think you guess llamas there.
Yeah. No llamas.
Oh,
I'm going to go with llamas.
No, I don't know. These... I think that in Germany they're getting much more cross-cultural.
That was right. I can't believe it.
You guessed it. Why not even trying?
Number six. According to the rules of Oktoberfest, the beer must be A, saluted by the crowd, B, aged in a barrel for 15 years, C,
whiskey.
If you're paying attention, from one of Munich's six breweries, or D, accompanied by a giant pretzel.
Well, that's my question, right?
Yeah.
Can you say those again? Please.
The beer must be saluted by the crowd, aged in a barrel for 15 years from one of the Munich's six breweries, or accompanied by a giant pretzel.
I think it's number two. I don't think any beer is aged. Whiskeys are aged 15 years, not beer. Really? I mean, is there an old beer like that?
No. You said... You selected the one that you said it's not.
Well, no, I'm saying, what it's not, right?
No. What it is. It must be.
Oh, must be. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I got confused there.
I'm not going to read them again.
No, I understand. A big pretzel.
There should be a giant pretzel involved.
Well, it's either that or saluted. But,
nine.
Yeah. Well, is it saluted then?
No, it's got to be from one of the Munich six breweries.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
I think we said that actually earlier.
Well, you know.
That's okay. That's all right. Okay. D. No, sorry. Seven. Whoa. Why do they call it Oktoberfest if it's really September? Yeah, we already talked about this.
Yeah, so I'll just say the answer that you said earlier.
Yeah, exactly.
Post.
What? This is Jerry.
Which was what again?
It's actually both B and C. I think that's what you meant, right? The weather was better in September and... The first one took place in October. I didn't say that earlier. I said the beat. Yeah. All right. Number eight. What is the official rallying cry of Oktoberfest? Oh, zap this.
Zap this.
Tap the keg. Tap the keg.
Tap the keg, yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Sis Boomba. Hakuna Matala. No, Matata. And Geron... Oh, Geronimo.
Geronimo. It's Geronimo. It's obvious. Obviously, we just...
Yeah, it doesn't start...
Oh, Zapstis.
Oh, Zapstis, auf eine friedliche Wiesn 2006.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, number nine, Dave. True or false?
Hey, this
is true or false. Children are never allowed in the tents during Oktoberfest.
Well, probably good reason.
Children not allowed in the tents? Well, yeah, if there's, it's like going into a bar. I'm going to say no, they're not.
Well, if they're
nine,
they're accompanied by adults. It's probably fine.
No, they're allowed. Apparently, it may come as a surprise, but despite all the flowing beer, Oktoberfest is family friendly, with carnival rides, carousels, roller coasters, musical showcases, and traditional parades.
Inside the tent.
All children under the age of six must exit beer tents by 8 p.m. Okay, so they do draw the line somewhere.
Crazy Germans.
Okay, Jerry, number 10. Which city is home to the country's largest Oktoberfest in the U.S.?
Oh, in the U.S., okay.
A, Los Angeles. B, New Orleans. C, Miami. D, Cincinnati.
I'm going to say D.
Oh.
Prost.
I think they have a fairly large German population there. I don't see Miami being a big German, you know, base.
I'm going to skip number 11 because we already talked about why I did the
Chicago's
first.
Chicago's pretty big, though, isn't it?
Yeah, that? We have some decent. We
There's
have
a
decent
lot
size.
Oh. Goes on here.
Well, we got a pretty big German population too, though.
Yeah.
But it's nothing like the Polish Independence Day parade.
I am going to go with the next question here, Dave. We already talked about this, but I like the answers. Why did the first Oktoberfest take place? A, it was originally a horse race in honor of a royal wedding. B, to commemorate the fall of the Berlin Wall. In honor of the first giant pretzel being created. And D, a national excuse for men to don lederhosen.
Well,
D.
That's why I celebrate.
Right. Whose question is this again? Is that Dave's?
That was Dave's.
Yeah.
I'm just going to give it to
host.
Him.
Oh,
yeah. Yes, of course.
Okay, this is perfect for you, Jerry. Number 12. Where a woman wears a bow on her dirndl dress is important. Oh, where she wears the bow is important. What does it mean? A, if it's on the left side, she's available. B, if it's on the right, she's taken. C, if it's in the front, she's a virgin. D, all of the above.
D.
Prost.
So if she has one on, she's saying, hey, come talk to me.
Right? Yeah, it says, pay attention to the ladies' dresses during Oktoberfest, as a little bow can tell you a lot about the person wearing it. If the bow is on the left side, it's understood she's single and willing to mingle. If it's on the right, her affections are already being given to somebody else. Traditionally, a virginal woman will place the bow in front of her dress. If you're looking to meet a man, it's a little trickier, since sadly, the same rules don't apply to lederhosen.
Where would you put that bow? But that's about the only time I'd be into something that's on the left.
Okay.
That's all I'll say.
There you go. Number 13. What is the most? This is Dave's. What is the most lost item in Germany at Oktoberfest? A.
Pride.
Clothing. Right. Clothing. B. Wallets. C. Live rabbits. And D. Children.
Hassenpfeffer.
I think of the numbers you gave us earlier, I think the largest number was clothing. At
Ghost.
Yeah, you got that.
A lot of bows get lost that night.
Man, we're only at number 14. We got to pick up the pace here. Number 14, Jerry, what instrument is most associated with German UPA bands? Oh, this is a classic. A, alf horn. B, clarinet. C, flute. D, oboe.
Alf horn?
Prost.
Yeah, I would have guessed that.
Number 15, how much beer?
I really don't know what an elf horn is.
Let's see. Usually, it's
that,
a thing.
A horn.
Isn't it like Ricola?
Oh, the Ricola commercial? I thought that was Ricola. Swiss, though. I didn't know.
Oh, maybe. It says originally used as a way for alpine farmers in Switzerland to communicate with people in surrounding villages. It's a way to calm nervous cows when it was time to be milked.
Yes.
All right, okay. Number 15. How much beer is regularly consumed during Oktoberfest?
Too much.
Enough to fill an Olympic swimming pool? Three swimming pools? Five Olympic swimming pools? Or 10?
Oh, man.
It's kind of tough. It's like... the answer is three.
Olympic swimming pools? Or
yeah.
Did it say Olympic?
It's Olympic, okay. Yeah. I just gave it to you because it's... Oh, good. I thought there were 25 questions. There were only 15. Oh, thank goodness. So.
Das ist gut.
Ein Prosit, ein Prosit, der Gemütlichkeit.
Gemütlichkeit.
SmorgShow Podcast.